The Snow Queen and Other Stories by Hans Christian Andersen. Read by Clare Corbett. The Snow Queen. First story, which tells of a mirror and of the splinters. Now then, let us begin. When we are at the end of the story, we shall know more than we know now. But to begin. Once upon a time, there was a wicked troll. Indeed, he was a very mischievous troll. One day, he was very pleased with himself, for he had made a mirror with the power of causing all that was good and beautiful when it was reflected therein to look poor and mean, but that which was good for nothing and looked ugly was shown magnified and increased in ugliness. In this mirror, the most beautiful landscapes looked like boiled spinach, and the best people were turned into frights or appeared to stand on their heads. Their faces were so distorted that they were not to be recognised. And if anyone had a mole, you can be sure that it would be magnified and spread over both nose and mouth.
"That's glorious fun," said the troll.
If a good thought passed through a man's mind, then a grin was seen in the mirror, and the troll laughed heartily at his clever discovery. All the little trolls who went to his school, for he kept a troll school, told each other that a miracle had happened, and that now only, as they thought, it would be possible to see how the world really looked. They ran about with the mirror, and at last there was not a land or a person who was not represented distorted in the mirror. So then they thought they would fly up to the sky and have a joke there. The higher they flew with the mirror, the more terribly it grinned. They could hardly hold it fast. Higher and higher still they flew, nearer and nearer to the stars, when suddenly the mirror shook so terribly with grinning that it flew out of their hands and fell to the earth, where it was dashed in 100 million and more pieces. And now it worked much more evil than before, for some of these pieces were scarcely larger than a grain of sand, and they flew about in the wide world, and when they got into people's eyes, there they stayed. And then people saw everything perverted, or only had an eye for that which was evil. This happened because the very smallest bit had the same power which the whole mirror had possessed. Some persons even got a splinter in their heart, and then it made one shudder, for their heart became like a lump of ice. But some of the broken pieces were so large that they were used for window panes, through which one could not see one's friends. Other pieces were put in spectacles, and that was a sad affair when people put on their glasses to see accurately and well. Then the wicked troll laughed till he almost choked, for all this tickled his fancy. The fine splinters still flew about in the air, and now we shall hear what happened next. Second story. A little boy and a little girl. In one large town, where there were so many houses and so many people that there was no room left for everybody to have a little garden, most people contented themselves with flowers in pots. In this town there lived two little children, who had a garden somewhat larger than a flower pot. They were not brother and sister, but they cared for each other as much as if they were. Their parents lived exactly opposite. They inhabited two garrets, and where the roof of the one house joined that of the other, and the gutter ran along the extreme end of it, there was to each house a small window. One needed only to step over the gutter to get from one window to the other. The children's parents had large wooden boxes there, in which vegetables for the kitchen were planted, as well as little rose trees. There was a rose in each box, and they grew splendidly. They now thought of placing the boxes across the gutter.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.